a conservation conversation with Botswana professor Joseph Mbaiwa and SCI's Marc.
Let me get this right. Botswana, a landlocked country. From every border, elephants are coming into Botswana and causing human-elephant conflict.
Yes, actually, elephants know where they are safe, where there are no guns. So when the hunting ban stopped in Botswana, so those elephants out there started moving into Botswana. In addition to the fact that Botswana already has almost half the elephant population of the whole of Africa. So we started having all these large numbers of elephants. The whole idea has been that you hunted elephants from community areas and you keep them in protected areas, in national parks, in game reserve. But now, because they were no longer hunted, they started moving to other areas where they're not supposed to be.
Aside from what you've already alluded to, how has the absence of tourist hunting affected community livelihoods and their contribution to wildlife conservation?
In Botswana, we had the community-based natural resource management program. This is a program which was bringing in communities into tourism, into conservation. So that program, ever since it was started in the early 1990s up to 2014, it had the hunting component as part and parcel of the conservation effort. But now when the hunting was stopped, what it means is that to some extent communities could, like I said earlier on, could no longer perceive wildlife as a resource, but as a nuisance, especially when it comes to elephants. To communities where there was no community-based natural resource management, poaching rates would be high. So what we are saying is, you make communities benefit from wildlife, benefit from safari hunting. These communities will actually promote conservation. You deny them the benefits from hunting, the benefits from wildlife. They will perceive these animals as government animals, not theirs. As a result of that, they will be not obliged to conserve them.
All of the research from who was in favor of shutting down international hunting said photo safaris would do the same, if not more, on the economic side that international commercial hunting did. You say what?
That is not true. Photographic tourism is not the answer to all the conservation or poverty problems in Botswana. If you believe that photographic tourism is the answer to all the problems in Africa, then maybe you need to do some research. For me, safari hunting is a conservation tool. Hence, we are saying reintroduce hunting, let the communities benefit from elephants, from hunting, and then at least we will know that poaching levels in Botswana will go down. Poaching coming from the local communities, it will drastically go down.
The amount of sustainable habitat that your country has versus the actual total population of elephants inside Botswana, that has to be sort of out of balance.
Yes. There was an elephant management plan draft that was produced years ago in Botswana. The draft says the rangelands in Botswana can keep up to 60,000 elephants. But now what we have is about 230,000 elephants. So what it means is that we have actually far, far, far exceeded the range. And it's not okay. It's like you have your range and you are told you are supposed to keep 30 cows and you end up with 200 cows. So you can imagine the amount of damage, the vegetation that you're going to destroy. So the elephant numbers that we have in the country are very high. And it's time we come up with a proper elephant management plan. that will actually make recommendations as to what to do with the large numbers of elephants. I'm of the idea that some of those should be taken to other countries. Mozambique is willing to get, they wanted about 500 elephants, take them there. Yeah, if countries want some elephants, they can get them from us.